Justice League issue 8 returns to the Legion of Doom's adventures as the Totality speeds through space in the year 1988. Scientists in Utah monitor it in hopes of capturing a piece of the energy 20 years before it would actually arrive on Earth. The satellite used to absorb the energy, however, explodes and the energy is shot down towards Earth, where it hits a man named Will Payton, who would use the Totality's energy to become the hero known as Starman. Starman, however, is attacked by someone who arrives from a hole in time. The man, revealed to be Lex Luthor, says that he has questions for Will about the end of the universe. In the present, Martian Manhunter continues his story about Starman, gleaned from the memories of Starman himself. Manhunter says that Will gave Lex crucial information that he then erased from Will's mind. The League are also alerted to the location of Vandal Savage's base, which Lex now controls. Manhunter says that there is still much to learn, and while they have the Totality, Lex Luthor is definitely still winning their battles, and there is no telling how far he will go to get what he needs. At the Hall of Doom, Luthor's team is assembled and grumbles about what Lex himself is doing. Lex walks deeper into the base through many magical security features in order to meet with the Batman, who laughs, who is more than happy to gloat over Luthor's defeat. Luthor wants answers, and the cosmic horror of a Batman says that he's getting close to winning and hopes Lex knows how rare what is happening is. Lex knows he isn't being told anything, and the Batman who laughs wants him to remember something, that Lex is talking to Batman, and because of this he's actually able to take down all of his defenses and knows where Lex has been. The evil Batman says that Lex wants to know what he's unlocking next, since he already has the Steel Force in the invisible emotional spectrum, and Lex thinks he knows, but he's afraid he's wrong. The Batman says Lex deduced he would be victorious against the Justice League, but wasn't, and still doesn't know why, and he will tell him why, but it will be at a cost. In Canada, Cheetah and Black Manta go after Proteus, aka Poseidon, who they learn is living in a nearby lighthouse. Killing their way to the building, Manta says that Luthor promised him power over the Atlanteans, and the first stage of their plan is already in motion, and if what Luthor claims will happen, he will get the greatest opportunity to get his power. Finding Proteus, they attack the old man, slashing his throat thanks to Cheetah using the Tear of Extinction to coat her claws with. Cheetah says that they will send Proteus to the Graveyard of Gods and make him release what's inside of him thanks to her slashing his throat. As Poseidon dies, he says that they will drown the Earth, and that is exactly what they want. Leaving Poseidon to die in the burning lighthouse, the villains set their sights on Wonder Woman as Poseidon reaches for his bottled ship. The Batman who laughs, meanwhile, gives Lex some advice, telling him to surrender to something bigger than himself and something that he actually believes in, and since he hasn't done that yet, that is why Superman still is able to beat him. Lex says that he's seen the future calling to him, and that it wants Doom, and that he can give it to it. As Lex leaves, having had enough of the Batman who laughs antics, the Batman says that the universe isn't destined for Lex, but it is destined for a woman, who Lex really wants to know the identity of. The Batman says that he needs to be released first, however. Lex agrees to free him and learns of Perpetua, someone whose name is written in every corner of the universe, and unlocking the seven powers she once wielded will unlock her as well. Batman and Manhunter meanwhile watch over the Totality, and John hopes the answers he will find at Thanagar Prime will yield results, but it might be already too late. Batman says that they need to stay humble while they find their answers, and in the meantime they need to trust in their instincts since they've done well by them so far. As they leave and talk about the mystery of the Totality, a female form morphs out of the trapped energy, unable to say anything to the two men that leave the room. Justice League issue 8 was another fun Legion of Doom-centric story that end-capped the Totality arc and set up the next few stories in really awesome ways. Lex's talk with the Batman who laughs this issue was pretty much a highlight for me, and it was great seeing Lex's hunger for power come through in it, showing what he's capable of doing when he wants something and when he hungers for it. And I like that he's just so intent on finding out the secrets of the universe that he'll actually resort to unleashing the Batman who laughs on the universe again, which is kind of messed up. I'm really looking forward to the next issue and the beginning of the Drowned Earth story. I'm going to give this issue a 9 out of 10. Hey everyone, thanks for watching my newest video. If you enjoyed it, you might also like to check out my other reviews here on my channel. You can also follow me on various social media platforms like Twitter by searching Matt_FOS, or even join the Comic Multiverse Discord server and chat with other comic book fans, including myself and Joel from Cape Joel. Want cheap comics and trades? Head over to the Book Depository with the link in the description to get the cheapest trades and comics around, along with free shipping anywhere in the world. Until next time, this has been Matt of the Fortress of Solitude. Thank you so much for watching.